Hi there, this is Richard Gibbons here from Anthology, and what I wanted to show you today was the new AI conversation in Blackboard. So here I am on a Blackboard instance, and we're going to use my Wild Florida course today. And within that Wild Florida course, we have Module 1, Introduction to Florida's Ecosystems. So within this learning module, I would like my students to have an AI conversation focused on Florida's ecosystems. So I'm going to add this as a new course activity. So I'm going to find the plus menu, click on create, and then I'll have the option for AI conversation. Now the administrator at your institution would have to have turned this feature on. So if it hasn't been switched on, you won't be able to see this button. So speak to your administrator if you want to learn a little bit more. Now, when I load up the AI conversation, I need to give the conversation a title. So I'm just going to call this Florida's Ecosystem. And the second thing I need to do is actually give the conversation a topic. So what is your current understanding of the impact of climate change on Florida's ecosystem? So this is the topic that I would like my students to explore. Now, it's worth pointing out that this exercise is currently set up to be a Socratic questioning exercise. So the AI bot is not going to confirm or deny anything that the student says. It's just going to move them through a series of questions around this topic and allow the student to explore their thoughts. Now, the second part of setting this up is the persona. So first of all, we've got a default persona here, but it doesn't really fit what I'm trying to achieve. So I'm going to give my persona a name. So the name that I'm going to go for is Sarah, and she's going to have a personality trait, which is a meteorologist. She's going to be Florida based, light-hearted and supportive. Now you've also got the opportunity here to edit the image. Now you can upload an image, you can use Unsplash to find an image, or you can actually generate an avatar here, and we will take what we know about the personality and try and generate a suitable avatar. The other option that you've got is to type a description of the kind of avatar that you're looking for into the describe an image box and then click generate. So it's come back with four options for me here. I'm going to use this bottom option just for the purposes of the demo today. Click next. Obviously we can zoom in, and that's what Sarah could actually look like. And we will add Sarah's image into there. So it feels like the student's interacting with a real persona in this instance. We've also got a complexity slider. So if you're teaching lower level students, you can move it down. If you're teaching higher level students, you can move it up. And that will alter the type of questioning that's taking place. Now I can hit save there. And then I've got the opportunity to preview this chat as the instructor. I'll come onto that in a minute. The final part of this exercise for the students is actually to reflect on the conversation they've just had. So in what ways did the conversation advance your understanding of the topic is the default, but you can obviously go in, you can edit that reflection question. So you can make it more specific, you can make it about the AI experience, you can make it about the outcomes, the weaknesses, the strengths the students identified through the conversation. So you can obviously change that reflection question. Now, before you release this to your students, we absolutely recommend that you preview the chat and actually try it out yourself as the instructor, just to make sure that it's got the right feel to it, that the topic is being explored the way that you would like it to be. Otherwise, you might want to actually change the topic at the top. So when you click preview, you get introduced to Sarah and you can actually start the conversation. So you can make an initial comment about this conversation, and then you can go through a series of inputs and actually answer these questions that the AI bot is putting forward to you, and start to explore it. Now, once you're satisfied that that is working the way that you would expect it to, you can reset the chat and then you can release that to your students. Please don't forget that you've got all of the conversation settings. So if you wanted to make this a non-formative assessment, you could set a due date, you could actually put a grade against this. You've got the normal kind of test options at the bottom. You might want to think about a time limit, for example, so that you're not having the students exploring their thoughts for 3 hours. You could just say, well, this is just a quick conversation. I don't want them to spend any longer than 10 or 15 minutes on this particular activity. So those options are all there for you. Now that I've checked all of this out, I'm just going to make that visible to my students and I'm going to close that down. And that is now available in the first module of this course. So now let's log in as a student and see the student experience. So we'll log in as Chloe. Chloe will be able to see the Wild Florida course, and when she opens up that learning module, she's already made a start on it, but she can now see that new exercise called Florida's Ecosystem. She gets all of the assessment information that she might want to review at this point before she starts the attempt, and then she'll dive straight in. So we've got the normal interface here. There's two questions remaining. The first one is the conversation. The second one is in fact the reflection. So Chloe can now start interacting just the same way you did when you previewed the chat and tried it out beforehand. You can now see that Chloe's avatar is coming through and interacting with Sarah quite nicely. Chloe's got the opportunity to explore her thoughts and share her comments and her knowledge around this particular subject based on the questions that are being asked by Sarah. Now, Chloe can explore that conversation as much as she would like to, but then at any point, she can move down to the reflection question and actually provide a reflection. So the AI conversation would say, really helped me explore my thoughts on Florida's ecosystem. She's found out where she feels she needs to do a bit more study and where to focus her learning next, which is very useful feedback. She's now completed all of the questions that are expected in this task, and she's got the opportunity to submit. Chloe can submit that, she gets the submission receipt and close that down, and we can see that that attempt has actually been submitted but not yet graded. Now from the instructor's point of view, we're just going to try and log back in as the instructor just for a second. So I'm logging back in as myself, Richard. We're going to go into Wild Florida. And I'm actually going to access it through the item itself. So I'm going to go into the AI conversation. I can see now that a submission is available for me, and I will be able to see that that submission has actually come from Chloe. So let me click on Chloe. So what I actually get now as the instructor is I actually get a copy of the student's transcript. So all of the transcript is there showing me how Chloe interacted with the AI conversation. And I also get the reflection question at the bottom. In what ways did the conversation advance your understanding of the topic? Now, I'm obviously able to offer up a grade here. I can offer some feedback and I can save these changes should I want to do that. So let's give Chloe a grade. I know I probably haven't set this up as well as I should have. I can provide some feedback here and then I can save those changes and then post that to the student in the normal way. So that gives you a rundown of how the AI conversation currently works. It's a Socratic questioning exercise. It's to allow the student to explore their thoughts on the topic that you suggest as the instructor, and you get full visibility on submission of what the student's been up to through this process and their reflection on it. So we hope you really enjoy using this tool. We're looking for your feedback. So please make sure you engage with us in the normal way that you do. So thanks so much for listening today. I hope that's been useful.